Hello, this is Spiritual Key back with another reading, and today we're going to be talking about Pisces. What's in store for Pisces in the month of May? What they should be looking out for? What's in store for Pisces in the month of May? What should they be looking out for? Okay, we have the Nine of Swords reversed. We have the Knight of Pentacles, the Six of Wands in reverse, and then we have the Moon card. I'm gonna say this, y'all really been working hard. And y'all really working hard on self, having sleepless nights. But it's like y'all are keeping certain things to yourself. Y'all not letting the right hand know what the left hand is doing. But at the same time, okay, I have two things. Working hard on yourself to the point to where y'all have all this money stacked up. And having sleepless nights, making sure that y'all doing what y'all need to do to make sure that everything is in order. And y'all keeping all that stuff to yourself. You're not letting the right hand know what the left hand is doing. It's like y'all moving in silence. I wouldn't be surprised if I haven't seen y'all on social media posting as much because y'all are working and striving. Maybe y'all trying to get that car. Maybe y'all trying to get that apartment. Maybe y'all trying to get our situation into a better situation, right? But at the same, but here's the other thing. This seeking approval, instead of relying on what you think about yourself, you kind of care what other people think. Yeah, they don't know that I'm really working hard, but they don't understand my struggle and all this other stuff. Nope, girl, shut up. Not everything is meant for people to understand, okay? And some people, they just don't care, okay? And that's fine. You shouldn't worry about what people think, and you shouldn't worry about getting that praise or approval from somebody. Yeah, it's nice for people to be like, dang, you finally got on yourself, but let me tell you something, not everybody's gonna be happy for your success, and that's just it. If you're living with somebody, and you're moving out, and you're about to move out, yeah, they might feel some type of way. No, they might not be encouraging. Damn, I wish that they would at least, you know, look, be encouraging for me, at least help me move, or at least, you know, be happy that I'm getting my own. Think about it. If you moved in with somebody, because this is what certain people do. I can speak for only what I have done, but I'm going to say this. Some people, when you move in with them, they might make it seem like, oh yeah, I took you and I helped you out, but really be told, I really am helping you out because I'm helping you pay bills. I'm helping taking off some of that stress from you because you got me splitting the rent with you. If you're not splitting the rent, I'm probably buying groceries, paying electric, cable bill. I'm paying some type of bill in your house. So basically, I'm taking some of the responsibilities off of you, whether I'm being a non-paid babysitter or whatever the case may be. But see, I was different. When I let family move in with me, don't worry about my rent. I got it by myself. Don't worry about nothing. Don't worry about my car. No, I got it by myself. Don't worry about nothing. You save up and focus on this. You're going to save up. You're going to get your car first. And then focus on getting you maybe a new job or a better paying job or whatever the case may be. Right? And guess what? Family member move right on out of here. Okay? Because ain't no point of, like, what the fuck? what's the point of letting you move in with me just so that you can help me out of my struggle? But yeah, you're trying to get your own place, so it's like you're taking on more responsibility. I think that's weird. But anyways, nobody, not everybody's going to be happy for your success, Pisces. Realize that. Realize people are not going to be, you know, your cheerleader in your corner. You might have, now, if you do have somebody that's like, yeah, you're moving out, that's what's up, that's nice and that's beautiful, but at the same time, you're over here seeking for that approval. You're seeking for that, you know, a person saying good job or, I fucks with it. You're seeking for that. You're not going to get it. Okay. And if you are getting it, something's not right. Okay. Something's a little off. And I feel like, you know, wolf in sheep's clothing. A person could be acting like they're happy for you, but secretly they're talking down on you or praying for your downfall. Secretly they probably don't want you to go nowhere. They really want you to stay. They really want you to fall on your ass so that way they still have you around. Okay? Or they could be eager to get you out so bad that they're trying to make sure that, oh, you gonna move out this time? Oh, but if things don't go as planned for you to move out that time, it's like, oh, well, you don't have my rent by. It's just real rude, nasty. And you should know and understand that you got options and you should be penny pinching, okay? Once you realize that you have options you are able to actually do for yourself, you're gonna be okay. And not relying on nobody else, you're gonna be fine. And not relying on people's, you know, I wouldn't say somewhat of an approval, but somewhat of wanting people to tell you good job. Wanting people to be happy for you. You gotta let that go, okay? Yeah, especially if it's family, yeah, or friends or whatever. That's my day one. They've been, they're not, it's like a bittersweet. It's a bittersweet feeling of having somebody that you thought you was cool with, that you know, y'all ain't got no issues, but then it's kind of like when they find out that, you know, you're doing better and that you're about to, you know, venture off, it's the cold shoulder, them acting weird, all of a sudden you can't have company, all of a sudden it's always something, oh, I might have to come to you because so-and-so tripping, oh, now so-and-so blaming their significant other of tripping, like, it's just weird, like, now, I would say focus on yourself. Do not get caught up in the middle, especially if you're staying with somebody and they have a significant other and, you know, they upset with you, but they're taking out on a significant other and that significant other is trying to come on and talk to you and invent to you. Bitch, stay out of it. It's none of your goddamn business. When they get to arguing, try to play sleep or if you can't, leave. Okay, because it's none of your business and none of your goddamn concern. You need to be on the island by yourself and pretend that you don't hear shit because it's none of your goddamn business. Fuck them. They need to work out their own shit. They shouldn't be bringing you into none of their drama because it's not, what Janae Ako say, it's none of my concern. Oh my God, I think she's a Pisces too. All right. Let's see. Now, single and dating Pisces. Pisces that are single and dating. Pisces that are single and dating. Alright, getting to know each other, romantic feelings. This could be the one worth waiting for. Oh, this is really sweet. And worth waiting for. Okay, I'm gonna say this because I don't know what's going on with some of y'all Pisces, but I'm gonna say this. Understand, especially it seems like y'all are being really busy right now. Y'all are focusing on y'all money and everything like that, and y'all are trying, y'all are dating and stuff like that. How can I say this? If they want to stick around, they're gonna stick around. If they feel like everything is worth it, like it is for you, they'll stick around. Now, I'm gonna say this, y'all need to be transparent, y'all need to be honest, okay? Don't sit up there and make a person seem like they're the only one when they're not. Let it be known that you are dating and that you are single. Don't make it seem like you just want to fuck with one person only and you ain't worried about nobody else when that's not the case. Okay? And I wouldn't post too much on social media. Keep it low key, because it seems to me that a lot of people, they kind of come in, they try to fuck up your happiness, right? So the thesis is going well, here comes somebody else out the goddamn woodworks trying to fuck up your happiness, and here they come. Or it could be a jealousy thing. Oh, I saw you with that bitch. Oh, I see you with, oh, so you with him? Oh, so that's how we do it? Oh, so you moving with him now? And a lot of y'all, it seems like a lot of people trying to come in and mess up happy homes, okay? And I would say this, if you was probably talking to somebody or something happened to where you had fucked up and you feel as though they're worth waiting for, I would, you know, give it some time, but not too much time. If you want to check up on that person and see what's going on, but don't let ego get involved. Don't be trying to hit them up when you see them with somebody else and you trying to figure out if they moved on or not. Don't be doing that. Oh, she posted with that. Oh, I was just checking on you. I thought it was cute to see you with your little boyfriend. Oh, was that your girlfriend that you... Don't be doing all that. Don't be doing all of that. Okay? Check up on me because you want to. Check up on me because you actually care. Check up. Matter of fact, be surprised. You know, surprised. I'm like, hey, what you doing this weekend? Oh, you want to go out? Hey, if you want to go out to eat this place, hey, you want to go race car, go kart, race, whatever the fuck. Mini golf is, celebration station, you know, main event, you know, whoop-de-whoop. Main event, that's my shit, okay? I still got some points, bitch, and I'm about to use them hoes this weekend. If my job don't come in, but that's another story. I was at the basketball game. Bitch, I was, what? Anyways, so like I was saying, be romantic, you know? Especially if you really feel this person. Because I'm telling you, the summer, people start showing their ass in the summertime. I'm just saying. Letting it be known, for some reason the heat do something to people. It really do. And this is like a nice good time to take vacations, like nice little vacations and stuff like that during the summertime. Because you know, the summer, the sun is out. Really nice. But that's what I'm going to say for y'all. If you really like her or him, hit them up and let them know that you put in the effort, that you care. Okay, now Pisces that are in relationships. Pisces that are in relationships. Okay, I got pay attention to red flags, wedding, release your ex, attraction, and deception. What's, child, go back to the drawing board. Sometimes you gotta weigh out the good and the bad. You gotta figure out, is the good overweighing the bad? Is this worth it? Because stop posting. Like I told some, y'all need to listen to me. wait a good 3 months, because a foundation should be good by then. Wait a good few 3 months, and when the 3 months end, you ask that person, where do you see us going? Do you want to take that next step to having a commitment to be boyfriend or girlfriend, be my man, and you be my girl? Like, y'all need to figure that out. Okay? And let go of certain things that, you know, I know some of y'all probably debating going back to your ex. You might have saw your ex somewhere and you saw how they look good, they look different, you know, but however, looks can be deceiving. They could be that same person, just with a different glow. Okay? Sometimes, maybe they have changed, and maybe it's just you. Or maybe they seen how you changed and they're trying to match your energy so that way you will come back to them, but it's like they're still the same person. Okay? And be careful with people. And be careful. Try not to make sure that y'all on the same page. Because I don't want y'all to be falling so hard for a person and y'all not even on the same page with each other. Okay? Because y'all do go with the flow. I mean, it's whatever you want. I'm with what you want. Stop doing all that. Okay? Because that's annoying. Stop doing that bullshit. What do you want? Do you want to move forward or do you want to be single? Do you want to continue this and move up? And, you know, some people are probably thinking about marriage at this time. Is that what you're wanting? What is it? Be clear what you want and stop going with the flow. Stop leaving everything up to that person. Bitch, what is your input? How do you feel? And I don't mean to call you a bitch. You know, when I say bitch, it's a friendly bitch. Okay? It's not mean. Especially if you're a man watching this. I'm sorry. I don't mean it like that. I promise I don't mean it like that. Okay. So what is the advice for Pisces? Okay, I got starseed. I got don't dim to fit in and protection. Yeah, don't dim your light to fit in. Like in the beginning when I said about seeking approval, or every time when you're able to do for yourself, everybody's not, you know, being, what's the word? Not congratulating, like, something about them not congratulating you, not being in your corner in a sense. I don't get the word that I want to use to sum up all that, but you get what I'm saying. You ain't gotta do all that. You ain't gotta lie and pretend like, damn, bro, you know, I'm still struggling trying to get this, to make a person feel like less worried about you upgrading and moving forward just to, you know, smooth their ego. Fuck them. Okay, fuck them, because, bitch, no. You should have dimmed your light. But however, I do understand about dimming your light to protect yourself, because sometimes when a motherfucker find out that you about to do this in the third, now all of a sudden, oh, you know, hey, I spent all the electric money. How the fuck did you spend your electric bill? See, that's the shit I be talking about. How the fuck did that happen? Bro, you know, my towel, bro, you know, baby mom, oh, you know, my boyfriend did. Okay, all of a sudden, out of the goddamn woodworks, all these problems are coming in. So I do understand about protecting yourself and stuff like that, but don't, you know, I can't tell you what to do. You know, you can do what you want to do. I'm going to just say this. Protect your light at all costs. Protect yourself and your energy at all costs. And y'all doing good, not letting the right hand know what the left hand is doing. that is good. You know, not posting much, not putting a business out there much. So when you do get your own place or your own car, it'll be a surprise for them hoes. And don't let everybody know that you got that shit. Cause you know, some people, when they find out you got something, and all of a sudden, hey bro, hey sis, can you help me with this? I see you got your car. Can you come? Oh my God, I don't have. Oh, now all of a sudden, you ain't got a ride here. You need a ride there. Now all of a sudden, can I spend the night at your place? Cause you know, whoop-de-whoop is tripping. Girl, my place ain't a safe haven. Like, you gotta do something. Cause it's gonna get annoying at that point. So only certain people should know. Okay. Only certain people should know. Matter of fact, once you get your own shit, I'll wait a month. I'll wait till the end of May to say something. Okay? If you want to. It's up to you, but I'll wait just to see how bitches is. Okay? Let's see how y'all are. Because what you're not going to do is all of a sudden you got issues and problems now that I got my own. We're not doing that. Okay, well, thank you for watching. That's the end of this reading.